liberado, geral. Tá liberado.
Solta! Solta, vem comigo, vem pra dança. Solta que essa dança é pra curtir. Sacudindo, vem no beat da beata. Depois que entrar, não vai como fugir.
Solta, vem comigo, vem pra dança. Solta que essa dança é pra curtir.
We begin our journey in Salvador da Bahia, the original capital of Brazil until 1763. UNESCO has declared Bahia a World Heritage Site due to its historical importance, cultural vibrancy, and aesthetic appeal. The energy in Brazil is fed by a strong undercurrent. A groundswell of social change is bursting from beneath. Salvador is the largest city in the northeast region of Brazil. Historically, Salvador was founded in 1549 and was the most important city in Brazil until the Portuguese declared Rio de Janeiro the new and present capital of Brazil. Salvador was the site of the colonial empire and the center of the slave trade. The majority of the people now living in Salvador are of African descent. Brazil is a cultural kaleidoscope of African-Brazilian culture, of history, music, dance, and religion.
Are these dances that these women have been working, are they authentic African dances, or are they more of a variation?
The way that society deals with sexuality and body changes from one society to other societies. So what is forbidden in certain cultures? And places like Brazil and Africa, including like all Africa, Black Africa, Mixed Africa, White Africa, you can feel the rhythm, the rhythm, and you can follow that rhythm with your body. You see this and from the belly dancers to the samba, to different manifestations of dance.
Prostitute was a forbidden culture. So people University of Detroit Mercy, majoring in international business. Just a few reflections about the Brazil trip. It was really an awesome experience. Looking back on it now, it's like an experience of a lifetime, like moments that you could never relive. Just the day-to-day interactions with the people. Now actually relating my experiences to international business, it's helped me out a lot. Right now I'm in a course of global marketing, where we actually have to do country analysis, talk about the countries, just the global perspective of what's going on. You kind of get a one-on-one live experience that you're able to relate to your classroom experiences, so it brings your coursework to life. The most memorable lecture that we had while in Brazil was definitely the one on media ethics. They kind of proved that there was a negative portrayal of African Brazilians within the media, or there wasn't much of a presence at all. So they're definitely fighting to get more of a presence. And it was kind of hard to believe. I'm like, what do you mean? Because here in the U.S. you see African Americans in the media every day. They showed us the ad for Melissa Shoes. I'm sure many of you have heard of the Melissa Shoe brand. And there was actually a Portuguese woman, a Portuguese Brazilian, and she was sitting down. And around her there were five Afro-Brazilian men, one fanning her, one on his hands and knees like this as a rest for her remote control, one feeding her grapes, and the other two serving her in some other manner. And it was just preposterous, because this is a recent ad. This is a futuristic ad of the 21st century. And this is something that can be commonly seen in the media. So it was kind of like, wow, you know, it is alive. It does exist. And that lecture really hit home for me. It angered me slightly. As far as affirmative action in Brazilian culture, only 3% of the people in universities are Afro-Brazilian, and that is a very small percentage. So they're fighting to change that, as well as fighting to get bills passed that actually teach Afro-Brazilian children about their culture. Right now, their history is not taught in the schools, and they're pushing to get that opportunity to have, so that everyone will be able to learn about Afro-Brazilian culture.
My name is Robert Lee Burke. I've learned a long time ago that the more I learn, the more I learn how much I do not know. And this program has shown me that I do not know a great deal about the one